Hey, Watch, I won't keep you that long. I don't, people got to get moving, and I appreciate your time. As Ziggy mentioned, I'm the owner of a company called Superior Strategies, a very proud member of the Red Rock First Nation, located just an hour down the road. Probably one of the only 100% Indigenous-owned safety training company, you know, operating in Ontario, as far as I know. And I also co-own with my partners from Kingfisher and Wanamin, a supply company. So again, one of the only 100% Indigenous-owned supply companies operating in Ontario. And one of the driving factors behind that was the call from corporate Canada to say, you know what, we're looking for Indigenous businesses. Where are they? Do they exist? So on and so forth. So we said, okay, well, here we go. We're going to open up the supply company. And it's been slow coming, but we are growing. We are seeing some positive results. Doing some work with some large organizations, including Enbridge, Gold Corp, the City of Thunder Bay, City of Toronto, those folks, and hoping to do more work with the communities. But we're a growing company and looking at a very bright future. I also started my own construction business called Nijitune Development Services. And again, I'm a firm believer that in order for us to invoke change as Indigenous people, we need to be in those upper echelon leadership type positions, and that includes ownership. And so that's what we're doing, right? But it's an uphill battle, I'm not gonna lie. It's been challenging. With the fight is daily to get recognized as an Indigenous business that can stand on our own and deliver. And like I said, we keep pushing. I'm very proud to say that, you know, I do walk the talk. So I am an ambassador for Indigenous inclusion. I have one of my colleagues in the back, Ron Morano. We recently started the Anishinaabe Business Professional Association to kind of challenge those questions around, you know, do your businesses exist? And we successfully started that. We recently completed a training program in Sulakup, in partnership with Parent Construction, for some of the Islam community members. And Bill Dilley, some of you may have met, is one of my instructors, and he was up there doing a great job. But just to talk a little bit about Superior Strategies, I started the business about 12 years ago. I'm very passionate about health and safety, and ultimately it was also a way to help pay my wife's way back to school, and seen the need and continued it from there. And I basically started out doing health and safety training, first aid training, and traveling around the different communities, doing a wide variety of first aid training. We are a training partner of the Canadian Red Cross. We're also an instructor developer, and what that means is that we go out and recruit and train instructors to deliver training for us. And I really would love to see more First Nation Indigenous instructors training to our own people, including the North. You know, it's definitely a cost savings if we could do that. I'd love to put a course on and train some instructors, so we're delivering right in the communities. We're also a Ministry of Labor certified Working at Heights provider. We do WMIS, confined space, all that good stuff. But I am a firm believer, and I know, I guess, I grew up on the reserve. I remember walking around the reserve as a snot-nosed little kid and you know, seeing faces in the different training we're doing. What I'm trying to change, though, is I'm trying to change the focus around training for the sake of training to employment, right? We all need to have purpose in our life, and we're all looking for an opportunity. And so we're trying to change that narrative, and it's important for us that, you know, we're helping work to find where the gaps are in employment and create opportunities and train and work with potential employers to fill those gaps. That's huge. I'm sure you're all aware that we have the upcoming Wataykininat project that's taking place, which ultimately I see as huge opportunity that we definitely do not want to miss. I'm sure you're all thinking the same way I'm thinking, is that we do not want to have the conversation again, you know, 5 years down the road, where it's opportunity lost, where we have all these outside organizations coming in making millions of dollars, and our people are sitting on the sidelines, you know, with nothing, right? I know I'm tired of seeing it. We on the eastern side, northeastern side of Ontario, with the east-west tie line, we're heavily involved in that. And I will tell you honestly, You know, you see the blue Valor trucks kicking around here. I'm one of those folks that are holding them accountable, saying, you know what? We have Indigenous businesses. We want opportunities. We want jobs. We want inclusion, right? And holding them accountable. And it's the same thing with the Wate project. I'm sure you're sitting there going, how do we get involved, right? And if I can be of assistance in helping, by all means, let me know. I will use my contacts to help that. But we also do employment-based training. I work with a company called OTEC, Ontario Tourism Excellence Corp, where we've done hospitality and tourism training, service excellence. We've done some remote line cook training, but a wide variety. And again, it's I will deliver this message. I get people calling me for TDG training, transportation of dangerous goods. And I'll coach you and say, you know, what are you looking for? Why do you want TDG training? Unless you're handling chemicals all the time or shipping bulk chemicals, TDG training is really, you know, it's really useless, right? Unless that's part of your job requirement. You know, maybe I'll offer some training or ideas of something that's more of a necessity, right? Or even, you know, I was talking to Bill about this. You know, we spend a lot of money on training. I know how expensive training can be. But I'd be willing, you know, if we can train our instructors in our communities to deliver in-house, I'll give you my program. I'll help you get to where you need to get to, right? We've all been down this path, and then I speak honestly about surface miner training and the Common Core training and all that sort of thing. I've heard this buzzword around our communities for so darn long, where it's Common Core, Common Core. You know, I want to help educate our communities as to what the Common Core training really is, right? Unless you have someone willing to sign you off and say you're competent, you know, you're not receiving Common Core training, right? That's the honest to God truth. And if I can help educate so that people get signed off, so they're actually getting their MTCU transcript that says, here, I have my Common Core, that's what we want to get to. That's what we want to achieve, right? And the same thing with apprenticeships, pre-apprenticeships, right? I don't like the term pre-apprenticeship. Ultimately, you're an apprentice or you're not an apprentice. So if we can get people to sign on as apprentices and start working, so we're building up those skill levels, that's what we want to achieve, right? I think we all want to achieve that. And I mean, grow trades, like Ziggy mentioned, going to trades, huge demand. Like, I think there's going to be 1,100 jobs in the region here, right? And, you know, I want to see our people fill those positions, making some good money, you know, 60, 70, 80, 100 grand a year, right? But I'm a firm believer that, you know, the reason why we're not filling those positions right now is these work environments have never been welcoming to our people. Okay, truthfully and honestly, I don't believe that's the case, right? OPG can sit there and say, we posted this job for Indigenous people, but I get zero applicants. Well, at the end of the day, that environment hasn't always been welcoming, so it's gonna take some time. You gotta build your culture, right? And that's part of what we're doing. Like I said, if we can help grow that, if I can help, you know, be a conduit to those conversations and share some of my network with you, I'm up for that, right? Like I said, I don't believe in going in there and training for the sake of training. I'll coach as much as I can to share with you some meaningful training, some contacts. But I believe the time is now. I think we're actually at a bit of a renaissance, if you may, where, you know, our people are all screaming for opportunity. You know, our youth are screaming for opportunity, and you know, there's enough work, an abundance of work out there where we cannot be successful. And so if I can share that, I see, you know, I got some other colleagues here, Shane, Fugere, Layuna, we're all really pushing the same message. And as Ekin attests, we've talked to him that we're all pushing. We all want the same thing. We all want to see our people on the work, on the job sites and working, right? And earning some good juniors. Sorry, I'm kicking books around here. But yeah, if we can do that, if I can help in that regard, please. I'm very fortunate that I have a very strong team working with me. And you know, like I said, I'll leave my cards here. Ziggy, if anybody wants to grab one of my cards, by all means, you know, feel free to reach out. I'm not the pushy salesperson. I'm not going to be calling every day. But if we can be of assistance, we're here. You know, I run my office out of the Lake Helen Reserve, and I have a training center here on Dawson Road in Thunder Bay, just on the highway. So, but like I said, one of the things before I close here is that I recently signed up for this program. It's called Skills Pass, And what it does is, I'm one of those companies where I'll do a lot of training and then somebody will call me and says, hey Jay, can you help me out? I lost my first aid card, or I lost my confined space card, can you help me out, right? So what we have now is we have a program right now where as soon as a person successfully completes a course, we enter it into SkillsPass, they get an electronic version of their card, so it's all, they always have it, right? It'll remind them of expiration dates. So there's no more calling to say, Jay, I lost my card. As long as you have access to the internet, you have a phone, you have your card on you at all times. So which is a pretty cool feature. We're happy to have that. Because like I said, I'm an industry person. I've worked in the forest industry, construction industry for a number of years. You know, so I've been fortunate in that regard. And I'm, like I said, I'm willing to share my knowledge. I've worked for, you know, some of the larger companies in some of the best managed companies in Canada, and I've had those experiences. You know, looking at procurement and training and those opportunities. I just want to share that knowledge I have, and work with the communities. And I said, you know, if you got members here in Thunder Bay that are looking for employment, don't be afraid. Give me a call. I'm willing to help out and make that contact. I can't guarantee miracles, but I'll work to help achieve those contacts. Right. So Meg Wetch, if you have any questions, I'll kick around here for a bit. If not, you know, kick me out by all means too. But Meg Wetch, enjoy your time here in Thunder Bay and have a great conference. Meg Wetch.